In this lecture, we're going to talk about the very important topics of confidentiality and privacy, and what we do with the information that we learn from patients. So the concept of confidentiality goes back centuries. So it's included in the Hippocratic Oath when it says, when I may see and hear in the course of treatment or even outside of treatment in regard to the life of men, which on no account one must spread abroad, I will keep to myself, holding such things shameful or unspeakable to be spoken about. So very clearly, it's been part of what a physician should do when they learn confidential information about a patient. They should keep it secret and not spread it out. So let's talk a little bit about what confidentiality is. It is an obligation to protect information obtained about a person, obtained in confidence. That's how we get the term confidentiality, or obtained in secret. It means that there's an expectation on the part of the patient that once they share this personal information with us, and it's being done for their benefit, that the physician or clinician is going to protect that information. And that then, when there's an expectation, entails that there's a promise within the context of that trusting relationship that the information will not be divulged without the patient's permission. Now, privacy is a larger concept, broader concept, that isn't just between, you know, the clinician and the patient and the confidentiality that they have within their relationship. Now we're talking about the philosophical notion of this is a basic human right of liberty, freedom, where we don't want others to intrude on our lives, on our privacy. And so this idea of allowing access to our bodies or to information about us is a right to privacy, that we're giving access, but still the other person needs to protect and restrict information that they've learned. And when the patient grants access, they're exercising their right, they're not waiving their right. They still have to have their right to privacy upheld and protected. Now, I see it as, confidentiality is the focus on the relationship. So it's really dependent on the trust that the patient places in the clinician to protect the information, whereas privacy is really thinking about the information and protecting the information. And it's because it's not just a single clinician that might have access to information nowadays. With electronic medical records, with multiple people on a healthcare team taking care of a patient, they have access to the information. So it's important for all of them to be protecting that information. So really thinking about it in terms of the privacy. And why is it important? So this is centered on ethical principles for why we need to respect confidentiality and privacy. It starts with respect for autonomy. So this is an autonomous action by the patient that they have the right to control access to themselves. That's a matter of their being self-determining. It also means that they have to consent, so respecting autonomy means we're getting the patient's permission to do things. So if there is any need to disclose information that we've learned, that the patient consents to that. There's the ethical principle of beneficence. So sharing this sensitive information truthfully is actually helping the patient. You know, if they're concerned that their information might be shared too broadly, they may not be so forthcoming. And that's going to interfere with us making an accurate diagnosis or figuring out the right treatment for them. So if they can share information truthfully, that's going to help them while we, treat them, make a diagnosis, give them the treatment that they need. And it also means that, you need to have this trust. So when it is that one-on-one relationship between the patient and the clinician, that trust entailed by the confidentiality that we've sworn to, if that weren't there, patients would not seek care. If they're really concerned about their privacy, maybe they're not going to be going to get their health care that they need. And lastly, the ethical principle of non-maleficence, so doing no harm. So when we disclose this personal information, we may actually cause harm. What are the harms? Well, you could damage the patient or family's reputation. So if it's very sensitive information, like having a sexually transmitted disease, and that gets out in the world, and this is going to damage the person's reputation, that is a harm to them. It may interfere with their relationships. So again, a partner has an affair, gets a sexually transmitted disease, that gets out there, that may damage their personal relationships. It may be a threat to their employability, their insurability, or even their housing. So there have been cases where people will be denied insurance for having a pre-established condition. If this diagnosis were not in the medical record and weren't protected, then an insurance company could say, well, I'm not going to cover you as an insured account for the insurance company. Or it might affect a patient's ability to get employment if they know that the patient has a particular condition. And at the root of this is going to be, it creates mistrust of clinicians or the medical establishment as a whole if there are these breaches of confidentiality. So very, very important to make sure we're protecting people's privacy. So I think when there are breaches of confidentiality, it may not be so much malintent by the clinician that they are doing this intentionally to harm the patient. Often it's going to be because of negligence. They just haven't put in enough safeguards to keep the information secure. So examples of this could be how do you convey information either to the patient or to their family members? You have to find a private space to do that, maybe a family meeting room where it can be more private. If it's out in the hallway or in an elevator, waiting room, there's potential that other people are going to overhear the conversation, and then that obviously compromises the patient's privacy. Nowadays, we also have to worry about social media. So maybe common for us as clinicians, we need to sort of unwind or debrief what's happened in our day. It might be an inclination to maybe talk about, the tough day you had at work of, the patients you needed to take care of. And maybe there's a general inclination to de-identify that information, but even just posting about the patient description, what happened, any kind of testimonials about the patient, or even, photographs, even if it doesn't have any name attached to it, that might be enough of identification that is a breach of confidentiality. It's also nowadays happening that patients are posting reviews of us as clinicians. And if we respond to those posts, that might be a violation of their privacy. We're reacting to something that they've put on the internet, and that may be a problem if we're directly addressing those concerns because it's private information about them. They can share private information about themselves, but we shouldn't be reacting to private information because we have to protect that confidentiality. So it's all very important to make sure we're being safe, we're being secure in how we handle this information.